It's day two of the maintainability arguments in the Tata Mistry matter right here at the National Company Law Tribunal. Counsels on both sides have finished their arguments for the day, but we don't have a final order yet. Let me take you through the highlights of today's arguments. C.A. Sundaram, arguing on behalf of the Mistry side, started off by saying that if the National Company Law Tribunal decides that the petition filed by the two Cyrus Mistry firms is not maintainable, they will be rendered remedy-less because the Companies Act, which is a special statute, bars the civil court jurisdiction. In his second argument, C.A. Sundaram cited various case laws to make a point that of late the Supreme Court has upheld purposive rule, one which takes into account the object of the act. In his case, protect the minority against the brute force of the majority. In his third argument, here Mr. Janak Dwarkadas, also representing the Mistry side, said that look, assume the equity shareholders start oppressing the preference shareholders by changing the duration of the redemption of their pref shares, or by changing or undermining the underlying security. Will in that case the preference shareholders not argue that we are a separate class in ourselves and we hold 10% of their class and ask for a remedy? Because in such a case, the equity shareholders will never join them in an action of oppression and mismanagement. After C.S. Sundaram and Janak Dwarkadas wrapped their arguments, Mr. Singhvi, representing the Tata Sons side, started off his arguments by saying that the Mistry side's arguments are designed to get out of the applicability of Northern Projects. Now, Northern Projects is a Bombay High Court case where the Bombay High Court interpreted issued share capital to include both equity and preference share capital. Abhishek Manu Singhvi said that the Mistry side is arguing that 2016 is a new act, don't get influenced by the 1956 Act jurisprudence, just to get out of the applicability of this case law. In his second argument, Abhishek Manu Singhvi said that for section 244, the corresponding section under the 1956 Act is section 399, and the language in 399 and 244 is exactly the same, other than that the provided that in section 399 has changed to subject to in section 244, and that according to him can't amount to a change in the law or the intent of the legislature. Also, on the point of language, he said that look, this language has existed for the last 59 years, and are you, the petitioner, telling me that in the last 59 years nobody has had the wisdom to challenge the wires of this section? In his third argument, Abhishek Manu Singhvi said that the petitioner is conceptually asking for a waiver before a waiver by saying reduce the rigor of section 244, which lays down the 10% threshold. Abhishek Manu Singhvi argued that this is a mandatory provision and the petitioner is seeking to convert it into a directory provision, which is impermissible as per the case law laid by the Supreme Court. In his final argument, Abhishek Manu Singhvi said, look at the language of 241.1a and 241.1b. He said 241.1a doesn't mention the word class, while 241.1b does. Now he says 241.1a addresses oppression and 241.1b addresses mismanagement. He says that if the argument or the calculation of the petitioner is upheld, then we'll have a different test of threshold for oppression cases and mismanagement cases. That's a wrap on the highlights from today. We'll be back with more on Feb 20th. That's when the hearing is posted for Abhishek Manu Singhvi to continue his arguments. Thank you for watching Bloomberg Quint.